All right, I'm really excited about this. I've got a new Sansi LED floodlight motion detector security camera. It's hardwired to 120 volts or 220 volts, and it's Wi-Fi camera, which is seems pretty good. I know exactly where I want to use this camera. This is some of the details about it. It actually says it's got 180 degree light and camera coverage. This 180 degree camera coverage is surprising to me. That'll be interesting to see if that's true. I'm hoping it is. And then the other thing I want to know is, how is the app going to work? Am I going to be able to use this with another camera system, like an NVR, like Blue Iris or something? This is the actual camera right here. It's got this mount, and then you can readjust these a bit. These go different angles, and we'll see how it goes. It says it's got two-way audio, so I guess there's going to be a microphone. Maybe that's this, and then a speaker. Where I'm going to put it, it's going to be too far away for anybody to be able to hear anything out of it, probably. But anyways, I'm going to plug it in first in here, because that's how I roll, and test it out, and then we'll go hang it up outside. So I've got the camera wired up to a cord so I can plug it in the house. And I've just downloaded the app. It's called Stellar Cam. It looks like you have to sign up with an email and a verification code and stuff. So it's all right, setup process is finished. Let's plug in the camera. Turn this thing on. Oh my gosh. Okay. That's bright. Should give us a voice prompt, it said. Whew. Reveals a lot of dust in my office I didn't know was here.
Need to be configured.
Okay. So it says it's ready to be configured, so I'm going to hit setup on this app. This one's going to be in the front yard.
Step one, fix the mounting.
Yeah. If you can't
hear the voice prompt.
I did hear the voice prompt. Power supply, is the light on the bottom of your floodlight flashing? Yes, it is. Okay, so now I get to put my Wi-Fi password in. Couldn't help it.
Connecting. Please read.
Please what? I don't know what she said. Please read? Maybe? Please read?
Connect to router successfully.
Okay, connected to router. That's actually a decently loud speaker. I think people might actually be able to hear that. I'm going to put it, you know, it's going to be under the roof, pretty high. Not quite second story high, but it'll be pretty high. Oh, the light went off. So things are still happening. It's probably calling the mothership. Okay, this front yard camera. Oh, thank goodness. Okay, so that was weird. It just said it was still trying to connect, and then it said it failed. But it's connected, obviously, because I can turn the lights on. Holy smokes. Ouch! Man, that's way too bright. All right, so who we got? A siren? Do you want to turn on the bell? Yes. Okay. That's cool. And then there's motion alerts. So if I move, oh my gosh. Okay, well that works. Let's see what other things we have here. There's motion settings. You can set a schedule, min, middle, or maximum as far as sensitivity. Okay, so it only detects events you care about, it says. Lighting settings, 24-hour mode. The sensor is on for 24 hours, or the light schedule. Schedule your lights to turn on and off automatically. Motion zone, adjust the infrared motion sensitivity and light duration. Okay, those are cool settings. Device health, it says it's online, it's got a name, it's got an ID, it's got a software version, a hardware version, and then it's got an SD card. I didn't see the SD card slot. So now we want to look at the live view. And there it is. Oh my gosh. Okay, movement detected. We want HD. Okay, let's do this.
Hello? Hello, hello, hello. I see you. Get out of my yard.
Get out of my yard.
Okay, so that That's pretty good. It's actually a decent picture. Oh my gosh, I gotta stop that. Okay, let's do this. Oh, come on. There. Oh, every time I move. Well, it's very sensitive. Anyways, so I finally got the camera hung up outside. Safety first. And this is how it looks. For some reason, it seems to default to SD, even though the camera is capable of HD. Maybe there's a setting to change that, but so far, I couldn't find it in the app. The motion sensor is plenty sensitive, but most importantly, these LEDs are super bright. That's the best part about this camera. The only thing I'd really say is missing from this camera is RTSP or some other way to incorporate the video feed from this camera into some other video recording software. For me, that's pretty much a must for any camera that I buy. It would just be really nice to have the ability to not need to use multiple apps if we have cameras from different companies. This is not a night vision camera. There is no night vision. If you turn the camera on without the LEDs, you don't really see anything but the inside of the lens. But with those LEDs on, it's like daytime out there. Overall, it's a good camera. The motion sensor is really sensitive. I'm surprised that the speaker is actually as loud as it is, but it's pretty decent. And again, the real selling point here is these big, bright, waterproof LEDs. Sansi is a company that makes LEDs, and they make a lot of LEDs, and they make really good, really bright LEDs. As far as I can see, this is their first and so far only camera product. As far as camera goes, it's pretty good. It's right up there with pretty much any HD security camera. But the real strong selling feature for this camera is these LEDs. That's what Sansi does better than other companies. So if you want a security camera with some super bright LED floodlights, this might be the right one for you. That's it. Thanks a lot. Adios.